Hello friends, I am Sanjay Gupta. I welcome you on my YouTube channel. My channel contains more than 800 videos related to various programming languages. You can search those videos through the keyword programming by Sanjay Gupta. You can also search my channel by typing my name Sanjay Gupta in YouTube. Don't forget to subscribe my YouTube channel. For queries, you can connect with me by following these details. In this video, I am going to discuss how you can convert a number whose base is other than 10 to a number whose base is other than 10. It means we are going to convert any octal number into binary, or binary to octal, or octal to hexadecimal, or hexadecimal to octal. So the number which we are going to convert is not decimal, and the resultant number is also not decimal number. So now I'm going to convert integer numbers first. So first, have a look on the steps. So first step is convert the original number into decimal by following the multiplication method. So you have to convert the source or original number into decimal first, and then you have to convert the decimal number into the required number, or you can say new base number, by following the division remainder method. So these two steps we have to follow. So let's understand these steps with the help of an example. So this is example one. Question is, we have to convert 11011, the number is having base 2, into octal number. So here I'm going to use the multiplication method. First, I'm going to convert this binary number into decimal. So I have identified the positions of each digit. So this first digit is having the position 0, then second digit position 1, third digit position 2, fourth digit position 3, and fifth digit is having position number 4. So this way, these positions are multiplied here with this formula. So first I have mentioned the number, and then it is multiplied with its base raised its position. So 1 into 2 raised 4. So 2 is the base of the number and 4 is the position of the digit, and the digit is 1. Similarly, all other digits are multiplied. The multiplication are added further, and the addition result is 27, which is decimal number. So 11011, which is the binary number, its equivalent decimal number is 27. So here I have performed only step number 1. Now I have to apply step number 2. It means I have to convert this 27 into octal number. So for that, I am going to use this division remainder method. So 27 is the decimal number. I am going to convert it into octal. So 27 will be divided by 8. So it will be divisible three times. So remainder will be 3. Then further we can't divide 3 by 8. So remainder will be 3. Now if we combine 3, 3, number will be 3, 3, and its base is octal. So 11011, which is the binary number, its octal representation is 3, 3. So this way I have converted binary to octal. Now example number 2, here I am going to convert octal number into binary. So first I am going to convert octal to decimal, and then decimal will be converted into binary. So for octal, I have identified the position. Position of 6 is 0, position of 2 is 1. Then I have multiplied these digits. So 2 is multiplied with 8 raised 1. Here 8 is the base and 1 is the position, and then 6 is multiplied with 8 raised 0. Then these multiplications are added, and finally the result is 22, which is decimal. So this is the step number 1. Now I have to apply step number 2. So here I am going to convert 22, whose base is 10, into binary. So 22 will be divided by 2 each time, and the remainder is mentioned here. So we have to put all these remainder values from bottom to up. So you can see the number 10110. This is the binary conversion of 22. So original number was 26, which is an octal number, and it is converted into 10110, which is its equivalent binary number. So I have applied multiplication method as well as division remainder method to convert octal number into binary. One more example is here. Here I am going to convert hexadecimal number into octal. So first I am going to convert hexadecimal number into decimal, and then that decimal number will be converted into octal. So you can see here 25A, three digits are available. Position of A is 0, position of 5 is 1, position of 2 is 2. And A will be converted into 10, because we can't use A for any calculation. So its representation is 10. So here I have multiplied the digit 2 with 16 raised to. Why 16? Because base of the number is 16, and position of this digit 2 is 2. That's why its power is 2. Then 5 is multiplied with 16 raised 1. So the position of 5 is 1. That's why 16 raised 1. And similarly, 10 into 16 raised 0. So all these multiplications are added further to find out decimal number. So 25A is hexadecimal number, and its equivalent decimal number is 602. Now I have to convert this decimal number into octal number. So here also I am using division remainder method. So 602 is divided by 8 75 times, remainder is 2. 75 is divided by 8 9 times, remainder is 3. 9 is divided by 8 1 time, remainder is 1. 1 can't be divisible, that's why remainder is 1. So we have to put all these remainder digits from bottom to up. So the final outcome will be 1132. So hexadecimal number is 25A, and its equivalent octal number is 1132. So friends, this way, by applying these two different methods, multiplication and division remainder method, you can find out conversion of a number whose base is other than 10, and that number will be converted into the number which doesn't belong to decimal. So after conversion of integers, now I am moving to conversion of fractional numbers. So here we are going to convert octal to hexadecimal. So first convert octal into decimal by applying this multiplication method. So here you can see the digits which are available at left hand side of decimal point. Their positions are 0, 1, 2, and the digits which are available at right hand side of decimal point, their positions are minus 1, minus 2. And with these positions, I have multiplied all the digits. So 1 into 8 raised to, here 8 is the base of original number, and its power is position of this digit 1. So here you can see the position of 1 is 2, that's why power is 2. For this 2, position is 1, that's why 8 raised 1. For 7, position is 0, that's why 8 raised 0. For 3, position is minus 1, that's why 8 raised minus 1, and so on. Finally, these multiplication results are added, and the outcome is 87.40625. So 127.32, which is octal number, it is converted into decimal. Now this decimal will be converted into hexadecimal. So now we are going to see how we can convert that. So here you can see, first we are going to convert integer part by division remainder method. So this 87 will be converted first. So you can see it is converted through this division remainder method, and the result is 57, which is in hexadecimal form. So here we have only converted its integer part, that is 87. Now we have to convert this 40625 into hexadecimal. So for that purpose, I'm going to use this method, which I have already discussed in my another video. So 40625 will be multiplied with 16, because targeted numbers base is 16. So result is 6.5. We have to keep the integer part only here. and the fractional value will be available here for further multiplications. So this 0.5 will be multiplied by 16. Result is 8.0. So integer part 8 is maintained here, and the fractional value 0 is available here, which can't be multiplied further, because if you multiply any number with 0, the result will be always 0. Now we have to put these two digits together. So result is 0.68. So this fractional part's hexadecimal equivalent value is 0.68. So finally, if we combine all the values together, so 87.40625 is converted into this 57.68. And finally, if we find out the complete answer, so original number was 127.32, which is octal. Then I converted it into decimal, that was 87.40625. Then it is converted into hexadecimal. So finally, result is 57.68. So this way I converted octal number into hexadecimal number. I hope you have understood whatever I have explained in this video. If you want to watch more programming related videos, you can subscribe my YouTube channel. If you have any queries, you can connect with me by following these details which are available in front of you. Thank you for watching this video.